The topic building block is not new. We had touched upon this topic when we discussed enterprise continuum and also during ADM phases. So, what is building block? A building block is a package of functionality defined to meet business needs across an organization. A building block has a published interfaces to access its functionality. An interface is a shared boundary across which two or more separate components of a computer system exchange information. So, a building block has published interface to access functionality. Building blocks may be assembled from other building blocks. For example, if there is an inventory system building block which tracks inventory of a warehouse, and to access the inventory application, say you need an authentication mechanism, then you can integrate a login building block which authenticate a user, and this login building block can be integrated with the inventory system building block. So the whole building block it may be a sub-assembly of other building blocks. Building block is reusable and replaceable and well-specified with stable interfaces. Building block specification should be loosely coupled to its implementation so that it can be realized in several ways without impacting the building block specification. The way in which functionality, products, and customer development are assembled into building blocks varies widely between individual architectures. Like if we consider a set of Lego blocks as a building block of your organization, so these building blocks can be assembled to create different models. Likewise, every organization must decide for itself what arrangement of building blocks works best for it, and model the building block according to its business needs. A good choice of building block may lead to a better way to integrate with legacy system and flexibility in creation of new system. Building block has two flavor. One architecture building block, also known as ABB, which specifies the requirement, and other is solution building block, also known as SBB, which specifies the implementation details. Let's look into architectural building block. Architectural building block relate to architectural continuum and is the requirement, and they define what functionality will be implemented. They capture architecture requirement, example business, data, application and technology requirement. They are defined in ADM phases A, B, C and D. And they direct and guide development of solution building blocks. Now let's look into solution building blocks, also known as SBB. Solution building block relate to solution continuum. This is the actual implementation and solution. They are implementation of architectures identified in the enterprise architecture continuum and may be either procured or developed. As seen during ADM section, solution building block appear in phase E of the ADM, where product specific building blocks are considered for first time. Solution building block define what products and components will implement the functionality, thereby defining the implementation. So as said earlier, solution building block fulfill or implement business requirement. And lastly, they are product or vendor aware. So, this covers the building blocks section. I encourage you to read chapter 37 from TOGAF document link as mentioned on the slide. Any questions, please drop me a message. And as said earlier, if you think it will help a wider audience, please post it in the discussion forum. Coming up next, quiz on the building block. Thank you, happy learning, and God bless.